Well, the top of the saddle's back on the lathe with the linear rails bolted on. What remains is to align these true to the spin axis of the lathe itself. To do that, I've got an indicator here, fairly rigidly bolted to these two odd pieces of aluminium, which is clamped in the chuck. It forms a very rigid mounting. I can indicate on this end of the rail, rotate it around, and then indicate on this end. When they're both the same, it's in alignment. I fixed the camera above the lathe so that the reading on the indicator in both positions can be seen on the video. Let's have a look at the actual alignment of this front rail. I've got the clock here registering on this end of the rail. It'll be showing about 2 thou at the moment, but I'll set that to 0. I have to watch the error of parallax here. Okay, that's set on 0 at the moment. I'll sweep the mounting point around about the axis of the lathe spindle, bring it down here, and well, we're reading about minus 11.5 thou. I've got all of the mounting bolts except this one fairly loose at the moment, so it'll pivot about this one, which was the closest point to when the indicator was over here. So I'll now push this in. Whoops, a bit much. I'll put that on 0. It probably won't be dead right when we get back, but we'll make the appropriate adjustment then. Coming back into our starting position, and that's reading about 2 thou out, so I'll re-zero that, go back to the other side. Oh, it's showing about 3 thou, too much, so I'll just come back a touch. I'll come back to, well, it's about 1.25 thou, so we'll see what we're like on this side. Well, it's showing about half out, but in the opposite way. So that, I reset that to 0 back at the other position. And there we are. That is almost 0. So what I'm going to do is just pull that back a tiny bit and tighten up this bolt. Oops, where are we? There we are. That's spot on. That's spot on 0 at that end, and that's fixed down fairly firmly. So that shouldn't move too much. Come back to this side. And we're about 1 thou too much. So just pull back there and tighten on this one. Now, with a bit of luck, we'll be more or less spot on. About 0.5 thou too much. Bring that back out a smidgen and test again here. The last thou or 0.5 thou seems to be arguing with me. So I'm just going to give this one little, whoops, one little tweak more. It moves when I breathe. But then we are talking about fairly small amounts. Incidentally, the distance between the two reading points is 250 millimetres, or very close to 10 inches. No, still 0.5 thou. 0.5 thou too little. But we are zeroing in on it each time. 0 again. And doesn't get any closer than that. So I'm going to call that aligned. Right, well, I've tightened all the bolts up along here, so one final check. We're right on 0. swing it round to the other side, 250 millimeters away. I'll swing it down. They're all tightened up and it's absolutely spot on zero. We saw previously how I aligned this rail at right angles to the spin axis. So the next job is to set this rail parallel to this one so that when the cross slide is on there and it's sliding on four of these blocks, that the movement of the blocks on this side move dead parallel to the blocks on this side. If they don't, then we'll get some jamming or binding of the cross slide. My preferred instrument for taking that measurement across there would be a micrometer like this one. Unfortunately, I don't have one that's this wide. As you can see, this one falls short quite a bit. I used some digital calipers and I measured at each end and I set them as close as I possibly could with the calipers. What better way to check if the trucks on each side move parallel to one another is actually measure off the trucks themselves, the movement of the trucks. What I've done here is I've made this little block out of some aluminium scrap. Here's a better view of the block that I made to hold the indicator. It's just a block of aluminium out of the scrap bin. I milled the other side flat. Four holes match up with the four holes in this truck on this side, so it clamps down like so. There's a hole here, a reamed 6 millimeter hole, and that is to accept the 6 millimeter extension on the indicator. Fit that in like so and just finger tighten up the clamp screw, which holds it quite solidly. And when that's bolted in place, we've got our accurate alignment device. Pretty simple, but very effective. So I can move this from one end to the other. I'll start up here. I've got another truck on this side, which I'll indicate off, and I'll measure from that same point, at that same point every time. So it's opposite now. It's showing a reading of 4 thou. Now, I normally prefer to work in metric dimensions, but this indicator is an American Brown and Sharp, and so it's actually calibrated in thousandths of an inch. Each division is half a thousandth of an inch. For those who only speak metric, a thousandth of an inch is 0.0254 of a millimetre. So at the moment it's showing 4 thousandths of an inch. So I'll rotate that round. You can see how solid this mounting is, because you've probably seen in some videos people adjusting the dial of a indicator and the needles bouncing about all over the place. That's a sure sign that it's not mounted rigidly. Unless you mount your instruments very rigidly, any measurement's a waste of time. So I've now got that set on zero. So I'll move the truck down to this end. And not down to the end. Line that up with the blue mark again. And I'll just focus in on the dial. I think that's about it. And, well, it's bang on zero. My initial measurements with these calipers came out far better than I thought. So these can move together. Yes, we're just on zero. The next part of the job, we're getting close to the end now, is to bolt the cross slide on top of these four trucks. But after we've fitted the ball screw in here and the oiling pipes on all four of these, which will be brought out to the ends of the cross slide for easy access. When that's all done, then I'll be ready to go through the alignment of the cross slide. Well, it's time to do the alignment of the cross slide itself, bolted onto the four trucks that move with the slides. I've got the indicator mounted up, which is connected back to the chuck, so that can be rotated around and indicated on the other end. At the moment, I've got this just bolted down very lightly, and because of the clearance between the bolts and the holes, I've got a certain amount of lateral movement. You probably can't see it too well on the camera, but if you watch the indicator, you can see that it's moving quite a bit. So that will give me an allowance for lining up before I finally tighten the bolts. I'm going to start this side. It's indicating just about opposite this bolt hole, so it's largely going to pivot about here. I'll just nip that one up a little bit tighter, so that will tend to give a pivot position, so it'll be mainly moving at the other end. Now, I know on the camera you can't see when it's in this position, but I'm just going to zero it. Right, so that's now been zeroed. Now you can see it over here, and at the moment it's showing about 5 thou. So if I pull that in a touch, it was showing about 5 thou that way, so I have to bring it this way. So that's set on zero now. Let's come back and see if this has moved at all. No, that's spot on zero too. So I'll just nip this one up and go back and check. Exactly zero. So this is now aligned. What I need to do is go round and tighten all of these bolts and then check again. I'll come back to you when they're all tight. Well, they've all been tightened up, so I need to recheck. I'll come back to my original starting position. That's showing about 1 thou on here, so I'm going to re-zero that. It's now showing zero. And let's see what we get on this side. Oh no, that's about 1.5 thou, not enough. So I'll have to fiddle about a bit with that, loosening some of these off. I'll come back and recheck my starting point. Well, that's on zero now. Well, it's only about 1/4 thou light, so I'll just bring that in a touch. So now I'll do another round of bolt tightening, and then we'll come back and check again. Right, that was the last one to tighten, so let's have another look. That's spot on zero. And so is that, that's spot on zero. This edge is now lined up at right angles to the spin axis. Now that's not terribly important. It doesn't really affect the use of the lathe, because what matters if you're facing, moving the slide in this direction, is the direction of travel, not the angle of this edge. This edge could be over like this and still travel in the correct direction, and the same in the Z direction as well, because you would set the tool in where you wanted it. Why I take the trouble to align this edge is because it's a useful reference when you bolt other tools onto the cross slide. It gives you a reference from which to line some of those up. This is one example of something that of some tooling that might get mounted on here. What it is, it's a holding fixture for single cylinder motorcycle barrel to hold it in place for it to be bored. Now there's a machine surface on here, and so that can be lined up with this edge, and then it's only got to be centered in this direction, which can be done then by moving the slide. Well, that's about it. I've got to bolt on the tool post now, and I should be ready to start making swarf. If you like this video or any of the others, please share, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to click the button to receive updates of any other videos. Thanks for watching.